Hello, I'm David Douglas. I'm going to talk about secure messaging. I'm a psychiatrist at the Portland, Oregon VA and the co-chair of the My Healthy Vet Clinical Advisory Board. So My Healthy Vet is a personal health record. You probably know that a personal health record, or a PHR, is a web-based set of tools that allow patients to coordinate their health information. And to really see the transformative effects of My Healthy Vet, you can just look at the utilization statistics on this page. 84 million visits, over 2 million registered users, 37 million prescription refills, and over 600,000 veterans using secure messaging. Now, these utilization statistics can be compared to those of other personal health records. And a big one was Google Health. You know, global internet brand launched a personal health record, and it was decommissioned. And if you look at the postmortem that followed why Google Health was shut down, it actually describes the inverse of what VA has done right. And so it turns out from the Google Health experience that patients don't really want to transcribe 30 years of their own outside medical records. They want the healthcare organization to serve up the medical records to them. They want a PHR that is going to add value by giving them access to information, allowing them to do things electronically that previously required them to go to the hospital or the clinic. So this leads me to the PHR triumvirate. That's my own term. These are the three things that a PHR should offer. If it does offer, it's going to attract patients. Number one is self-service transactions, and prescription refill is a good example. I mean, there's a reason why we have 37 million prescription refills. It's because patients want to do things for themselves that they used to have to go to the hospital for or make a phone call. They want access to their data. It's the data that the healthcare organization has on them. And finally, they want electronic communication, and that's secure messaging. So secure messaging is a secure electronic communication medium between 600,000 plus veterans and their VA healthcare team. It's the approved means of electronic communication with veterans, and it's a key component of virtual care. So it's all about connections. We've talked about connections and the relationships. Secure messaging is an improved, efficient way for veterans to contact us. And just today, in the back of the room, while we were talking, I got a secure message from a patient, and without leaving this auditorium, that veteran now has an eye appointment that he asked me to arrange for him through secure messaging. So it was a great and very timely example. I swear I didn't set that up. So again, you think about the triumvirate: self-service transactions, access to information, and also communication with the healthcare team. That's what's allowed My Healthy Vet to achieve the utilization statistics that a global internet brand like Google couldn't do. The appeal of secure messaging overlaps with the appeal of email. It's durable. If the veteran can't remember exactly what was in it, they can go back and read it again. It's legible, it's not handwritten information, and it's efficient. It's an asynchronous communication medium where the veteran can send me a secure message, go off about his business, I get it an hour later, I can respond to him when I have time. The two parties don't have to be connected the way they are on a phone call. So secure messaging is new, but it's really just the latest chapter of a three-decade story of how the VA has continuously used information technology to reinvent itself and improve the way we deliver care to our veterans. And many people in this room know this story, but I love to recount it. In the 80s, we automated hospital processes like pharmacy and laboratory. We got our first taste of how technology and process reengineering and the use of data would lead to improved quality outcomes. In the 90s, we built an electronic medical record, CPRS. We deployed it across the largest centrally directed healthcare organization in the country. Every VA medical center in the country was using the electronic medical record. And that really set the stage for dramatic, really stunning gains in the quality of care in the VA. It was described in Best Care Anywhere, and again in a sequel to that book, big improvements in quality, safety, cost efficiency, and patient satisfaction. And up to that point, we'd really focused most of our technological efforts on our own providers, on our own healthcare organizations. Well, the time is now to focus technology on our patients, and that really was the segue into consumer informatics and the growth of secure messaging. So the idea of consumer informatics exists outside the VA, And there have been some very impressive goals that have been set by visionary leaders. There's Eric Dishman, the Chief Innovation Officer for Intel, and he's calling for 50% of Americans to be receiving virtual care by 2020. And on the right, we have our own visionary leader, Dr. Petzl. He wants 50% of veterans to be getting virtual care by 2014. Now, this isn't just a case of our visionary leader can beat up their visionary leader, although I know he probably could. This is all about setting a strategy for the VA so that the maximum number of our veterans can take advantage of this technology and achieve the transformative goals that will improve their health care. So what does virtual care look like? It looks like this. An empty waiting room on the left and a veteran at her home on the right with her laptop computer communicating with her doctor. We're tracking virtual care modality. Here's some recent statistics on how we're proceeding towards that 50% goal that we want to hit by the end of next year. And you can see that secure messaging is accounting for about two-thirds of that activity. We're going to try to keep growing the program to hit the 50% goal just as Dr. Petzl wants us to. So secure messaging, it's 21st century medicine. It continues that story of using process reengineering, data, and technology. It improves the lives of our patients. And I'm going to stop now and show a brief video that will allow a couple of our veterans to tell you what secure messaging means to them. We need to use technology to reach out to patients so that they have access to information, decision support, and the ability to communicate with us using technology.
Dr. David Douglas is a pioneer and advocate in bringing secure messaging to the VA community.
In the old days, your interaction with the patient was limited to the time of the scheduled appointment, maybe to a phone call. Now that we have secure messaging, I can communicate with my patients 24/7, you know, any time of the day or week that they contact me or I need to contact them, we have the ability to communicate.
Devin Nosbaum, a veteran of the war in Iraq, describes how secure messaging works for him.
I really like using secure messaging because I can do it whenever and wherever from my smartphone. If I'm walking down the street, if I'm in a coffee shop, if it's 2 o'clock in the morning and I have a thought or a question about my health or medications or almost anything, I can message my doctor right then and there. I don't have to wait for 8 to 5 Monday through Friday to make a phone call.
How's things been going?
Very good. I'm still very grateful that you taught me how to use secure messaging on my mobile phone.
When I do see the doctor and I've already talked to him about secure messaging or we've already exchanged messages on secure messaging, we can kind of put that issue aside and talk about the current issue that I've showed up at his office for or whatever checkup we're doing.
The service is available to all veterans, from Devin, who grew up with the internet, to veterans who served before the electronic age, like Vietnam veteran Larry Ubel.
Well, I first met Dr. Douglas, and he introduced me to this program and asked me if I'd want to be a part of it. I said, well, yeah, you know, I'm not a high-tech, you know, type of person. I'm kind of old school, so it's, and I still like that, but I found it really easy for the secure messaging, and it's been great for me as far as being able to contact Dr. Douglas during some times that I needed to talk to somebody.
Stay in touch through secure messaging.
You bet. Thanks.
What the process of secure messaging can do for the patient is it just takes a lot of stress out of having to leave their home, maybe if they're disabled or don't like being out, or it's hard to get to the VA through buses or taxis or something like that, having to arrange a ride. It makes it a lot easier to interact with your doctor wherever and whenever from your home or from your smartphone.
There are over 500,000 vets using My Healthy Vet to communicate with their doctors. Dr. Douglas's goal is to have all veterans using the program.
To veterans and also to my physician colleagues, I would say jump in. The water's fine. You'll be very happy you did. Secure messaging is a huge improvement over 20th century communication medium. It's more efficient for us, it's more efficient for the patient, and it'll make you do a much better job of providing care for our veterans.